Okay, so a few of you have asked how this clock sounds on Westminster. So I've had to take it down off the wall because there is no chime selector on the dial, as you can see. I never liked this clock on Westminster, so I just covered up the chime selector lever. I think I actually took the protruding part of the lever off. Now I'm going to try and make this clock chime on Westminster. The only way you can get this to chime Westminster is to pull this part out. That's what slides the chime barrel. The movement is by Haller. You see the sliding chime barrel? It's adjusted with this lever here. That's not the original pendulum, by the way. So now back on the wall, it is safely back on Whittington. It's been suggested to me that this high note bellow is actually a quail bellow, which is possibly the case, although it has this plastic bit here where the whistle sound is made. The slot is actually down the side. It could be a quail bellow, but I've never seen one made in the era where plastic was common. Mind you, I shouldn't say that, because I had a regular cuckoo clock, which is quite new, a regular cuckoo quail clock, which was quite new. But I think they are a rarity these days. They do exist, but they're not very plentiful. In other news, my Dutch clock has packed up. It still ticks, but the time is stuck at 12:30 because the motion work has packed up. So I need to take it to bits again and find out what's happened to it. This large mysterious object is very near to completion now. Well, it's Saturday night, it's 11 o'clock, and I'm afraid it's getting close to bedtime. Isn't that sad when somebody's going to bed at 11 o'clock on a Saturday night? Well, if you like this video, please click like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.